Hello and welcome back to another fun and exciting lesson. This one is all about color preferences, and as you know, everything we do in Photoshop is visual. Regardless if you're working on a brochure, a photograph, or designing a website, I bet you would like to have your file print exactly as how you see it on your monitor. What would be the point of spending hours on a file, or even 10 minutes, and then have it come back from your professional lab and look nothing like what you created? Everything you do in Photoshop should look the same in the print. At some point, you will have a project file come back from your vendor, or even if you're printing at home, you're going to notice the colors are not the same as on your monitor. So in order to ensure color accuracy and have an efficient workflow, you must understand, set up, and utilize color settings for specific projects. And this can be done with the color preferences options to specify the color settings for that project. So to access it, you're going to go up to edit and scroll all the way to the bottom and select color settings. Now, setting up your color preferences is an important first step for ensuring that your output matches what you see on your monitor. There are other factors that will also affect your color output, and that includes the type of paper you're using. Even the color and texture of the paper could create a color shift, plus the type of ink that is used can affect how your images appear when printed. For example, if you're using an in-home printer, then you will be using RGB color profiles, and if you're sending out to a professional lab to print for, let's say, brochures, then you may need to use what is known as CMYK for the color space for printing that particular project. We're going to go into more details on some of these subjects when we get into the section on color. For now, let's look at the different options for your color settings. At the very top, we have a settings drop-down menu. And if you click on it, you're going to see additional options from which to choose from. Now, depending on the version of Photoshop you have, you should have some of these options, or you may have other ones as well. And it also depends on if you have any type of printers already connected to your computer. If your printer is attached and you're not seeing it in the drop-down menu, then you need to actually load the printer profile settings into Photoshop. So you're going to need to refer to your printer manual to locate and load the color settings into Photoshop. So selecting the proper color setting for that project that you're working on will help ensure that what you see on your monitor is what you're going to get when you output the file for print or for the web. Although remember that there are still other factors that can affect the color output, like your ink, paper, and even the type of monitor you have, and whether or not it is color calibrated. Again, we're going to go into more details about the color settings when we get into the section on color. For now, let's just leave all these default settings as is. If you did make some changes and wish to save it, then make sure you click OK to commit those settings to your current project. In the next lesson, I'm going to show you how to customize your menus in Photoshop for your own personal workflow.